Is he breathing?
No, he's not breathing.
It's early afternoon on the air desk, and dispatcher Andy is listening to a 999 call from a golf course. A golfer has collapsed.
All right, OK. Someone's giving him CPR. OK, so you need to try and make sure. Try and find out if there's a detail about the golf course, OK?
It sounds like a heart attack. With no life-saving defibrillator on site, other golfers will have to perform manual CPR until the paramedics get there. Matty and Gav are racing to the course on the outskirts of Leeds with Dr. Neil.
Visor's down. All good, boy.
The ambulance service has dispatched some additional resources as well, so they may be on scene before us. Or given that it's a golf course, we may be there first. The chain of survival is key, and the first chain of that survival is both calling for help and accessing an AED, an automated defibrillator.
Guys, they'd asked if there was a defib at the golf course, and I don't believe there was one. Depending on how far on the course he is, we might be the first defib at sea.
It's a 10-minute flight for pilot Jeff.
There's quite a few golf courses around here all merged to one. There's White, Brandon and the Morality all together.
Hang on, visual, 3 o'clock.
On your right, Jeff.
Now going into 5 o'clock,
Jeff.
Yeah, I've got the DC here.
Visual scene. Everybody locked in tight?
Yeah, all good.
All right, I'm going to turn it around because it's pretty slopey, isn't it?
They're landing on the fairway. It's as close to the patient as possible. Local paramedics are already battling to resuscitate 57-year-old Carl Booth.
Son's recognised that he's been in cardiac arrest, been given very good CPR on arrival. He's had 3 shocks at the moment, he's just had his first adrenaline. He's in persistent VF.
Okay.
And that's where we are at the moment.
I'll be there, wait. I'll get the corporals.
Yes.
Medic 2 to Medic 1, could you grab the corporal CPR advice for us?
I'm going to be on there. Sorry, I'm not running.
27, 28, 29, 30, another one and then a rhythm.
Yeah.
It's 20 minutes since Carl collapsed, and there's no pulse or breathing.
Has anybody had a conversation with the son yet?
Yes, I've had a chat with him.
And you've got some medical history and background?
No, not that sort of stuff at the moment.
I'll go and have a quick conversation. So they're doing chest compressions on his chest because he hasn't got a pulse and his heart's not working.
OK.
And we're breathing for him with the device that's in his mouth with some oxygen.
Right.
He's really poorly.
Yeah,
and it's much better for me to be honest with you and say that he may well die. His heart has stopped.
Okay.
I'm sorry to be blunt.
No.
But I think it's better to be honest.
Yeah.
What history has he had in the past with his heart? Has he had any heart problems?
Nothing at all.
Still in VF? Yeah, back on.
Okay. Back on the chest.
The defibrillator can shock a heart back into rhythm.
Okay, oxygen's on the way. Run back. Shock in.
This is the 4th shock Carl's had in a matter of minutes.
Back on.
With no success. Paramedics keep going. With good CPR, patients can recover after a long time in cardiac arrest.
23, 24, 25, 26, 27.
Carl was playing a round of golf when he collapsed in front of his horrified son, Sean.
Half an hour ago, we got onto the 8th tee. He had to take a sit down. Really, really sweating. Could hardly respond to me. And then he sort of came round completely, took his golf shot, finished that hole. And he went, I'm just going to go back to the car, and I'll come with you. He went, no, go play that. Played my first shot, and I've come on, and he's got his hands on his knees, and then he just collapsed.
Spasmatic. Please, go on.
Carl isn't responding.
Hey, mate, currently had 4 shots, we'll look at it further.
I'm your adrenaline, Rob. Adrenaline.
I'll get some fluids up.
Yeah.
A shot of adrenaline is Gav's last chance to restore a heartbeat.
Your
autopulse?
Yes, we're just sorting it out, it's here now.
The autopulse is a machine that will take over the chest compressions on the way to hospital.
Stop rhythm check.
There's a flicker of life.
Do rhythm check for a separate pulse. Can you check for a pulse? VF, back of the chest.
For a moment, Carl's heart restarted, but then it stopped again.
Are you happy with chest up and down and we've got CO2?
Yeah. Gone back, gone clear, jock in, back on.
Yeah, CO2
is at 2.5. The core pulse is ready.
Yeah.
I think we're getting the scoop out, is that right?
Yeah, we'll get him onto the scoop and then if we can do that.
Do you want scoop first and then slide it underneath?
Yeah, I reckon so, yeah.
Okay. You need to turn yourself around.
Matty, scoop first, then slide core pulse in on the scoop.
Yeah.
Carl's son, Sean, is shaken.
Rhythm check.
They've now been working on his dad for 25 minutes. With every minute, Carl's chances of survival dwindle.
Shocking. Back on.
A defibrillator at the golf course could have made all the difference for Carl.
Guys, the rule is towards me, get this rope on and we can get him on the floor full CPR.
The heart rhythm is still not normal, which is why his heart isn't working at all. Okay. So the plan is to take him to Leeds Hospital with life support ongoing.
Okay.
But I still don't think the outcome is going to be good.
Okay.
Carl's only hope is immediate treatment by cardiac specialists in hospital.
Right, guys, let's roll in now. Guys,
let's
do another adrenaline.
Done. Adrenaline's in.
That's it. Okay. Yep, go. It's a bit of suction there. Small catheter, Neil, if you've got one.
I'll get you a suction catheter, Gav. There's a normal one for now.
With the auto pulse fitted, Carl is almost ready for his journey.
Guys, everybody away, please. Clear, check in.
Watch that cannula as well.
Do you still want the suction?
Yes, please, if you've got it, yes. Are we getting ready to move then?
Yeah,
do it. Dr. Neil fears if Carl does survive, he could be brain damaged.
Let's wait, do another shot, and then we'll get him on.
Gav, are we going with him or not?
I'm happy to go if you have to, you don't want to.
Yeah, I mean,
I'll go, and you and Matthew go with
you've been running it.
Yes. Yeah. You go with the aircraft.
You can go with the crew.
Yeah. That's fine, yes, yeah. I'll see you at LGI.
We'll take our tips.
Yeah, I'll see you at LGI, yeah.
Patient is still in VF.
Watch it, watch it.
Yeah.
All right, let's go then.
Carl's heading 6 miles to cardiac specialist by road on blue lights, so that Gav and the team can continue CPR on the way.
They're just about to leave scene, mate. Myself and Neil are going to come in the aircraft and we'll go pick Gav up from LGI. Received.
The gentleman himself is really poorly and his heart has stopped. I was able to have a conversation with his son. As a medic, we don't always appreciate how much we know and how little they may not recognise what's actually going on. Medical interventions that we're doing can look quite aggressive, for want of a better word.
The air ambulance crew have done all they can here. Even with their best efforts, Carl's chances of survival are looking slim. Against all the odds, Carl Booth made a full recovery in hospital after collapsing on the golf course with a heart attack.
The medical staff, I'm led to believe, brought me out of the induced coma because the family was there to actually visit. When I actually kind of woke up and recognised them, so kind of straight away, they were over the moon that I'd actually was still sort of able to sort of like kind of talk to them, because they'd been told potentially I was very badly brain damaged with the amount of time that I'd been down on the golf course.
Carl spent weeks in intensive care and owes his life to the golfers who stepped in and performed CPR until the paramedics arrived.
I think it saved my life. The medical stock and the people have been talking brilliant as well, but the actual bystanders were absolutely fantastic. Well, I know a lot of people wouldn't, but these people just went for it.
Surgeons fitted stents in his heart and an internal defibrillator to regulate its rhythm.
And what you get is a little sort of app on your phone, which talks to the defib, which I think is fascinating. If anything happens, it actually sends a message to the hospital, and they sort of get you sort of straight in. So. Great stuff.
Carl and his family fundraised for a defibrillator and proudly presented it to the golf club.
If the defib machine had been actually at the course when it happened to me, things may have been a little bit better than people having to do sort of kind of CPR on me. That's actually one of the sort of things that I wanted to do when I started coming back around and getting out of hospital, was to actually kind of make sure that that was available, and then any extra funds that we've got available we're going to put towards the air ambulance, because again that was sort of, vital to helping me recover.
Carl's recovery astounded the doctors. He's now back on the fairways playing golf again.